welcome to episode 3. Today we're going to start with some basic work here. I'm going to show you the first session of items that I bought. I do have the OEM Nissan parts coming in about a week, the full tune-up. We got the cap, rotor, spark plugs, air filter, fuel filter, oil temp sensor, coolant temp sensor. I do stick with OEM for more of the critical parts, all the sensors, O2 sensor, stuff like that. But today, I bought a few things for some work. Started out with the owner's manual, which you gotta have so I'm not constantly on the forums looking for help. I can find most of the answers here too, so over the long term it'll be good to have. Got the 3M rubbing compound. I got a bunch of waxes, and those aren't gonna cut through these deep scratches all over this thing, so I'm gonna try some rub out and do some waxing on top. An extra long Phillips to tighten my valve cover, see if I can slow down that leak a bit. A wheel brush, which is just nice to have for any of my cars. The hood supports. I wasn't going to go Nissan on these because it's not like a electronic part or anything. The Nissan ones cost about double. These were about 25 a piece. Both of them are shot on the hood, so I got to use a stick, so it's going to be cool to get those in there. Bought some power steering fluid. It's the only one they had. I gotta see if it's the yellow or the red type fluid, make sure it matches before I pour it in. I remember in my day there was the yellow and the red. I can't remember which one this is, so I'm gonna find out. And of course I got some applicators. These are cool with the built-in handle there, so you really can get a good grip on it. So these are new things I saw. I said this looks pretty good. Of course you got the terry cloth style for the wax and polishes applications. The microfiber, which is extra soft for the polishing, cleanup, rub down after that. I also have microfiber cloths to use later. So let me see what I'm going to start with here. I have one of the hood shocks off. What this entailed was prying the clip up on both sides. Then you pop off the ball, and this one looks a lot different. I did check his spec book and it is the right one, so I'm gonna go ahead and continue on this. I'm going to remove the two factory contact points and figure out how this is going to, there it is, how this is gonna connect, and I'll show you the results in a few minutes. Well, it turns out that that first one I took out has the incorrect or a different style with the ball on the end. As you saw, this is the proper connection to fit that one, so nothing that can't be solved. I'll just use a bigger washer on this first one I'm about to complete my install on. The second one will be easier because of those connections you're looking at. I did find just the right bolt, which is a little thicker head like the other one, so it probably will go in far enough. There is a big hole behind this, so it's long, but it should work. I'll see how this hooks up. It might be a little overkill, but I do like to put a dash of the anti-seize on the bolts. It's not necessary. Anything you see in these videos is to be used at your own risk. I don't claim to be a professional or anything. It's just using all the lessons I learned in the years I was a mechanic. So I'll throw a little bit of anti-seize on there just to make it go in smooth. I like to do that with almost every bolt I put on. The second one is out. It had this big proper Phillips bolt for the big hole, as we saw. This side is all original. It has a riveted bracket, which is a pain. So I just got to drill that out. I'm going to take a drill through this rivet so this comes out, then reuse the bolt and nut that came in the new strut in place of this permanent rivet. And this is how it should have looked according to the hardware I bought. The other one was a bit odd and replaced, but this is the proper method. So I'm going to drill this out and use the new bolt. And the final result Well, strange. They're not strong enough to push them up, but I don't need a stick to hold it anymore. You got that. You got that. So this is all set. The hood shock job is done.